Good morning. Keith Krigo from Web Dev by the Bay. I currently have a project where I need to limit the a date range for the user. I have a start date and I have an end date. And I have a button on here and I have three labels that serve that will show the error messages. And why do I have three? Well, the first one is for the start date. The start date cannot be prior to the current date. The other two labels are for the end date can also not be before the current date, but it also cannot be before the start date. And the way I set those, let me go to the start date calendar control, and I will go to its on change property. And what I'm doing here is I basically determine if the selected date is prior to today, the current date. If so, I set a start date error boolean to true, and I set the error message to start date must be today or later. If it's false, if the date selected is good, then I reset the boolean and the error message. Now for this also will pop up the error message if the date is prior, but it also disables the submit button. And for the submit button, I change its display mode depending on if there's actually three errors going on here. There's a start date error, can be before today. There's an end date before the start date, meaning the end date must come after the current date or the start date, I'm sorry. And it must be today or later. It cannot be yesterday. So I either set the display mode of the button to disabled or edit. Now there's quite a bit more going on here with the end date. Let's go to its on change property. Okay. So I am actually doing three checks here, determining if the selected date is prior to today. Then same thing I did with the start date, setting the boolean, setting an error message. This is a good point. I wanted to set these to the same error message and error boolean value. That does not work because you'll end up in a condition where the values will get set at indeterministic times, meaning that you could have a false positive. Now, so I made these their own separate messages and error message and error value. Okay, let's go to the selected date cannot be before the start date. I do the same thing. This is also different from here. They have their own unique variables. That's important. The last change is if there's an error, I set the controls. Let me back up. I set a context variable value to the color red if there's an error. If there's no error in my form, then I reset it back to black. And reason that's important, I have my context variable also controls the text color of these two text boxes. This color for this text box is set separately. It is set just doing if there's a start date error, I just give it the color red. I don't need to set it back to black because the visible property is set to what did I do there? Why did I set that true? What am I doing here? Oh, duh. A little too early in the morning, I guess. So, I reset the error message to blank, and the text, this label is always visible, it's always visible, but it has no color properties, has no background color or border colors, so the user won't even see it. But the text will show either the message or a blank value. And that's what I have so far. There are some other little use cases that I will update from time to time. And that's a quick tip for Power Apps calendar controls. Thank you. Have a good day.